Hey, what's up, guys? This is Dirt Nasty from the Trademark Clan. Welcome to another installment of How to Make Advanced Warfare Play More Like a Video Game and Act Less Like a Dumpster Fire. Okay, I'm going to talk a little bit about the config file and how it's written and some of the things that can help this game play better in your config file. Now, I do realize that Sledgehammer says that they frown on any changes to the game that give a player an unfair advantage, but this is not really giving you an unfair advantage. It's just basically making the game play better. It's going to improve frame rate. It's going to improve ping. Just basically make the game a little bit more manageable. Because, right, you know, without these changes, trust me, the lag is just absolutely terrible. Okay, so when you go to your program folder, it's going to be in whatever drive you have it installed on. Program files x86, Steam apps, common, and there are their games, Advanced Warfare, and then Player 2. Now, the config file is config_mp. Right off the bat, what I suggest is you make a copy of the original config file, call it a copy, and leave it in that folder. Okay, then you can make changes to your config file, and worst case scenario, something doesn't go right, you don't like it, whatever, you can delete that and put your config file MP back in its original place and you're good to go. Okay, so any changes you make, make sure you make a copy before you make changes. Okay, literally the only thing that I've changed in the game is the way the network handles the game and the way my video card renders the game. That's all this is. Okay, so the following entry is basically it is going to be, this is the number, the new number, this is the old number. If they're the same, leave it, just go to the next setting. Okay, if it's not, then change it to what I have here. Okay, these changes also are published in the Steam community forums, so they're available, they're visible, and they're known, but this is just basically put them all together in one spot where you can watch the video. Okay, user set UI browser from one from 0 to 1. Browser show empty from 1 to 0. Show full 1 to 0. Server status. This is crazy right here. This basically reduces the amount of timeouts in the server. Okay. This changes, this is actually increases packet duplication, so it allows your UDP packets to continue to be broadcast to the network. Okay. Max ping. Okay, by default, the max ping in this game is 800, which is absolutely insane. Okay. So what you want to do is you want to take your average ping, whatever it is, mine just happens to be 70, roughly, and add 30. Okay. It's about 100. But if you find that you're not getting any games, you're not getting any matches, you might increase it to 125, 150, I'd say 200 max. But that's definitely better than 800. Okay. Max packets is 100. This is a line that you'll have to completely install if it's not already there, which it's probably not. Snaps is also 100. This is all related to networks and network packets. Okay. Install this entire entry. Okay. Okay, the next group of changes is going to be related strictly to video card. SM enable, ragdoll enable, max simulation ragdoll, limit. You're going to set your monitor to be 1. If you have dual monitors, it doesn't matter. The game will only play on 1, so you have to set it to see only 1 monitor. Okay, this entry is going to be installed. This is going to tell the game that you're using a multi-thread device like a dual core, quad core, 6, 8 core. So it's going to look for those multi-threads. Okay. HUD motion, blood, brass, and lighting. These are all turned off. And I've run these in the game. For example, the one game, Solar, the sun isn't as bright. Some of the effects have been reduced a little bit, but it takes a load off your card. It helps increase frame rate while you're playing, especially in critical motion. Sometimes you'll see a spike in frames when you turn, twist, jump, dodge, whatever. This will help reduce that a little bit, so that way you don't get that spike and that delay. But these changes, like I said, these have only been made to help the networking and the video card side of the game, and it actually has improved my gameplay a little bit. Not a whole lot, a little bit. Just a little disclaimer here. If you're going to make these changes, these are at your own risk. These are not, you know, you don't have to make these changes. You can change it back anytime, but do it at your own risk. I've been making changes to config files going back to Modern Warfare 2, Black Ops 2, Black Ops 1, Modern Warfare 3. And those changes have really helped the gameplay, especially in Black Ops 1. The gameplay in that game was so bad. But making changes to the config file dramatically increased the quality of the game, the speed of the game, and the enjoyment of the game. So there you go. There you have it. If you guys want to give this a shot, see if it helps you out. You never know. All right. Thanks for listening.